covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News at 5.
The Everglades, our investments here have been historic. And frankly, a great fear that I have is that there will be a U-turn.
The other part, if you're looking around.
A member of President Obama's cabinet takes a swing at Florida's governor when it comes to the future of the Everglades. Thank you for staying with us. I'm Tiffany Kenny.
I'm Victor Blackwell. The Interior Secretary, Ken Salazar, you saw him there, toured the Everglades by boat today.
Water quality seems to be the biggest issue going forward. The governor responds in a moment. But first, Kathleen O'Toole reports.
We're 1 month into a historic agreement between the state of Florida and the Environmental Protection Agency to address water quality issues. The U.S. Secretary of the Interior came to Boynton Beach today to see just why this is so crucial. A beautiful ride through the Loxahatchee National Wildlife Refuge is not quite that to the trained eye. This dense vegetation is too dense, fed by polluting phosphorus. Fish can't live here. Native species are being forced out.
It unfortunately grows up the canopy. And
Secretary of the Interior Ken Salazar got to tour firsthand portions of the refuge that are still healthy, seeing how water quality is vital in these headwaters to the Everglades.
This has been an effort that has been nonstop and ongoing, and we're at a really critical point here.
There's renewed optimism for some about the health of these waters because of an $880 million agreement between Florida and the EPA to fund stormwater treatment areas and a flow equalization area. It also sets phosphorus levels.
This sort of historic agreement is the first time that there will be a phosphorus limit, an actual restriction on the amount of phosphorus that can be discharged from the stormwater treatment areas, the wetland treatment systems that take the phosphorus from the farms out before it comes into the Everglades.
Salazar says of the restoration projects in the vast lands he oversees, the Everglades are the most important. But even through these serene waters runs a vast current of politics.
When Governor Scott was elected to be governor of Florida, one of the greatest concerns I had was that there was a U-turn going on in terms of investments in conservation and support for what we're trying to do here with respect to water supply.
The governor says he's shocked by Salazar's comment, saying, quote, knowing how hard we've worked on our historic agreement to restore water quality and flow to the Everglades. He goes on to say he cares deeply about the Everglades and recognizes it as an international treasure.
Politics aside, the tour included one airboat breaking down and the media boat having to use GPS coordinates to find the Secretary of the Interior. Salazar is old hat at all this. At one of his last stops, he actually got out and helped push a broken down boat. Reporting in Boynton Beach, I'm Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25.